Hello all you Pixel people, I am Pixel and welcome to a brand new Let's Play on the channel. Today, we are going to be starting Return to Castle Wolfenstein. Now, the reason why I've chosen this game is quite simple, to be honest. It's because Splash Damage, the company behind the game that I plan to cover quite heavily in future, called Dirty Bomb, actually made a free version of the Return to Castle Wolfenstein multiplayer called Wolfenstein Enemy Territories, and that was a very, very successful game on the PC for many years. And to be honest, a lot of the same kind of feeling and mechanics have made their way into Dirty Bomb. So what I thought would be quite cool is to actually go back and play the single player version of Wolfenstein. And even though some of the mechanics are a little bit different, like the accuracy and the way that works is a little bit different, I thought it would be a fair amount of fun. So this is where we're at right now. So I'll let you know straight off the bat, I've already played the first two levels while testing to make sure my settings were okay to record, and I died a few times, so I carried on playing these first two levels so I kind of truly understood the mechanics, because the way that the spread works in this game is a little bit strange to anybody who's not from the old school genre of games. Also, I have installed a HD texture pack, which means that this game now looks pretty damn awesome. And we're not going to waste much time, we're going to go straight into this. We're going to do it on Bringemon difficulty, which is normal. I am Death Incarnate, it's a lot of fun, but it's a lot of deaths, and I want to try and minimize that as much as I can. So we'll watch as many of the cutscenes and read as many of the notes as possible, and I hope you enjoy. We'll probably do a level per episode, because it is split up quite regularly, with each episode taking about 10 to 15 to 20 minutes, it really depends. If there's one which is super short, then I may do multiple episodes in a single, multiple parts, or multiple chapters in a single episode. But yeah, let's get to this, and we'll watch the original cutscene. There is no subtitles that I could find, unfortunately, so you're going to have to listen quite hard, guys.
Come in. Well, Jack, have we heard anything?
Yes, sir. We've just received a coded transmission from Kessler, our contact in the Kreisau Circle.
And?
Both agents have been captured and are being held in Castle Wolfenstein.
Damn. Call a meeting, Jack.
Yes, sir.
All right, gentlemen. Now let's go through it again by the numbers. What did we miss?
Well, here's what we know. This is Castle Wolfenstein, located in the Harz Mountains of northern Germany, property of Heinrich Himmler. Now, we've known of the existence of Castle Wolfenstein for some time, but we've only recently heard reports from our Kreisau Circle contacts in the German resistance regarding bizarre occult rituals taking place there. Now, these characters are part of Himmler's newly formed SS Paranormal Division, a small but elite group comprised of members possessing above-average IQs and backgrounds with the occult and or paranormal. The one in charge is this woman, Helga von Bülow.
Oh, wow,
our Kreisau contact in one of the villages below the castle has informed us that she and other members of the division have been recently deployed to the area. The Kraut with the monocle is one Wilhelm Strasse, also known as Death's Head, a brilliant and ruthless scientist who heads up Himmler's Special Projects Division.
Special Projects? It's marvelously vague.
How
well,
British!
We know it encompasses all manner of advanced weapons research, including rocketry. It's also rumored to involve ultra-secret research into chemical and biological warfare.
Charming.
Yes, what was?
But at the moment, we don't know how it ties in with this massive archaeological dig near Castle Wolfenstein.
So, advanced weapons, rocketry, chemical and biological research. Now, the occult.
Still doesn't add up.
Well, that's why we sent our boys in there.
Hey, Blaskowitz.
Jack, what are our options here?
Well, we could send a backup team in behind them.
Or
we sit tight and hope that they can find a way out.
It's your call, sir.
Leave me, why don't you?
Looks like we play the waiting game.
Oh, brilliant.
Okay. Looks like we're actually getting into this. Orders are as follows. Infiltrate Castle Wolfenstein and investigate increase in activity from SS Paranormal Division. Gather any intelligence information you may find regarding the SS Division and their activities in the area. Kessler, your contact is a member of a German resistant group called the Kreisu Circle? I have no idea. He has managed to partially infiltrate the SS Paranormal Division's temporary headquarters and has valuable information regarding their activities. Meet Kessler in the village near the archaeological dig site. He will have further information regarding your mission. Remember, if you or Agent 1 are captured, escape at all cost. Standing Order Number 71 remain in effect. If you are placed in a compromising position where you might divulge information regarding your mission or the OSA, take your own life by ingesting your cyanide tablets. As always, the OSA will disavow any knowledge of your identity and the mission if you are compromised. Good luck. So in other words, you get completely ignored if you get caught. And I do apologize, my reading is awful, guys. I really do struggle. That sounds marvelous, doesn't it?
Come in, Sergeant. Come in. Your orders, Herr Doctor. Go and get the other one. This one is almost finished.
Jawohl.
Now, let's try it again, shall we? Who do you work for?
Oh, that's gruesome. I swear these are war crimes. Like a boss. Okay, so we finally got control. Hey. Sorry, fella. I know that you're just doing your job. It's a 9-to-5 kind of thing going on here. Now, Wolfenstein has got a lot of hidden secrets, like most of these old school games, so you need to be careful and try and not miss them. I'm not going to search for every single one because I assume some of them are in crazy positions. Hello.
Ah, there you are. Shackles that one to the wall and takes the other one off the table.
Sneaky, sneaky, stabby, stabby! 1990. Is that Agent 1? It looks like he's quite messed. Sorry, mate. Trying to just get rid of the evidence. That doesn't seem to be working, though. What does this say? Very little information was divulged by this subject. He was subjected to 77% standard current before dying. We discovered a cyanide tablet hidden in a compartment of the subject's boots. This discovery leads us to believe that he and his accomplice are allied spies, although we have not determined at this time which agency they may be working for. I believe that I will achieve better results from his accomplice. Time of death is 15:35. Sorry, mate. I'll avenge your death, don't worry. I'm sure we'll figure something out. Nothing. Oh? I'm gonna shank this guy in the back. Stubby. Oh. Oi, die! Hello. Come on, Bobby. Where are you, mate? Like, when you're crouching down and you're not moving, the weapons are really accurate, but as soon as you start moving in this game, like, your shots just go absolutely everywhere. Which is kind of strange. It's not what you'd expect, really. I can't remember if there's any secrets around here, but might as well check. No. No, 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 no. I'm not going to read all these guys. It'll take far too long. So I'm just going to leave them up. If you want to read them or you can pause them. I'm giving them a quick read. I can read faster without speaking it out loud. This HD texture pack really does make a huge difference, doesn't it? I can hear somebody coughing. Oh, that door's my door, isn't it? Ouch. Hello. Good night. The music's changed. I don't know if that means that someone's going to come through this door or not. No, it doesn't look like it. Anything? I found a secret area. I don't really know what the idea of getting all this gold is, but you do find a lot of treasure in Wolfenstein. I think it's more of a throwback from the old games, and an alarm has gone off, which is great. The way that you know if you can destroy something is when you're next to it, you'll get like a symbol, so I can pick this up. I can throw it, and you can break it. Oh, so I'm back down here again. You can still do the old school bunny hopping as well, which is pretty cool. Which is strange, because you've got a stamina bar for your bunny hops. Oh, wow. Sorry, mate. You made me jump. Did not expect that. Nighty night. Oh wow. Shadow storming. Coming through. Taking too much damage here. Hey. That alarm is annoying. Shh. Quiet. Ah, there he is. He's normally always stood in this corner. I don't know, maybe he mixes things up from run to run. It's like a sniper without a scope, this thing. It's really accurate, but I find it almost useless. Like, I know there's a guy stood somewhere around this area. And when I open the door, it's like, no. Free shots. Hello. Oh. Oh. Where did you come from? It's making me wonder if I missed something now. No idea. We'll just collect what we need. Come on, Hitler. No, no secrets. No secrets. No secrets. That looks like a doorway, though. Okay, so back through here. That does look like a doorway, so... Hey! I found a secret over here. I did find a secret at the very end of this level as well, which was quite well hidden, to be honest. I don't know why I'm using this weapon. I absolutely despise it. I think it just feels nice when you actually get a hit. Like that. Yeah, let's switch away from that. Let's have some fun with grenades. Good night. Oh, that sounds yummy. Hey, giblets. No, you don't. There's something behind there. Come on, open the door. Oh, wait. Too obvious, too easy. Oh, wow. There you go. Oh, cleared like a boss. Like the first couple of times I ran through this level, I must have died like 10 times because it might look like it's quite easy when you know whereabouts the enemies are going to be. But when you don't, like a quick spray of 4 or 5 like bullets just, will completely melt you. Like so fast. It's crazy, really. Physics, guys. I don't think there'll be anything behind these. Actually, I think I can see. There's nothing behind that. Yeah, there's nothing behind those. Oh, just walking past them drops them. That's quite funny. Now, this is the one that I found by accident because I thought there was somebody behind here. So I came here and I saw that. I pressed that. I was like, huh? Huh? It's amazing. It's amazing. And I get a goblet. Which, like I said, I don't have a clue why you're collecting treasure in this game. I assume it's just for points. Point scoring. But yes, this is the first level complete. I don't know how many secrets I got, but we'll see. All right, so you can actually just stand here and actually see. So that took us 13 minutes or 14 minutes. We did both of our objectives, found all 7 secret areas, got all 9 treasures and did it in our first attempt. Bear in mind, I've done this level recently before and I've done the next one as well. But after that, I have no idea what to expect, guys. So if you're new to the channel, don't forget to slap that subscribe button for some more PC gaming goodness. And as always, like the video if you like the video. I hope that you do enjoy this series, guys, and I will catch you again in the next video, which will be up in the next day or two. So, thank you, and keep it locked. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.